One side effect of the pandemic is that there's been a lot less agitation from activist investors. I mean, normally we got a ton of proxy fights right at this time of the year. This year, not so much, at least aside from E.l.f. Beauty. Yes, the digital-focused value cosmetics company that we've had on the show before. Earlier this week, a smaller activist firm called Marathon Partners announced that they're nominating three directors for E.l.f.'s board. That's an eight-person board, and this one's real tough to handicap, frankly. On the one hand, the stock has been a significant long-term laggard. It's done next to nothing since it came public in 2016. But on the other hand, in the last year and a half, E.l.f. has really gotten its act together. The stock's up nearly 100% since the beginning of 2019. It's been thriving ever since. Wow. Just last year, the company reported a fabulous quarter. It's because as a digital-first brand, they're perfectly poised to handle the current environment. Now, I think they're doing a good job, which is why I wanted to hear management side of the story before these activists got too far into this thing. So let's check in with Tarang Amin. He's the chairman and CEO of E.l.f. Beauty. That's eyes, lips, face. Get a clear sense of how this company's doing and how he'll fend off these activists. Mr. Amin, welcome back to Mad Money.
Thank you for having me, Jim.
Well, I got to tell you, Tarang, first of all, it's good to see you. And you look healthy, and that means a lot, and your company's doing well. And that's what I'm trying to figure out about what this takeover battle is about, because you couldn't be doing better than E.l.f. is doing. And yet they seem to want three people, which then to me would be a payload to owning your company. So give me your side of things, because they seem to think that you're underperforming. But I look at all the rest of the industry. I think you're doing fine.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. And we do feel great about how the company is doing. I think the last time we sat down together was in 2019. And really, this company's been around 16 years, and almost every single one of those years, we've had very strong growth. But in 2018, our company declined 2%. So I do believe that that 2% was a real wake-up call for us to say, how do we get back to our roots and what we're capable of doing? So during that time, we basically put together five strategic imperatives that we've been executing against ever since. I'm proud of the fact that we've had five consecutive quarters of year-on-year sales growth. We've been taking major market share. We're only the only brand in the top five that's growing share right now. And as you mentioned, our total shareholder return since January of 2019 has been great. So I love the path that we're on as a company.
Now, I know in your conference call, you did mention that, look, in the 4 weeks ending April 18th, we saw pretty significant declines in the category and in health. But I mean, that's everybody. One of the things that really bothered me about what these three, they want the three people on the board, is that this is a worldwide calamity. It isn't like something that happened to you.
Well, that's right. And I think, you know, certainly in the first number of weeks of COVID-19, we saw the category contract quite a bit, and we were not immune to that. Yet in the latest data, in the last 4 weeks ending mid-May, our consumption was up 11% in a down category. So I think it really speaks to our fundamental value proposition and our digital engagement and really our ability to continue to execute.
At the same time, you are very big and getting even bigger in the world's largest retailer in Walmart. I see you everywhere in Target. I mean, this seems to be a tremendous time of expansion for your company.
Well, it is. And, I think we have our top two customers in terms of Target and Walmart are both doing well. Our business with them is really strong. In fact, so strong that Walmart later this fall will be expanding even more space on E.l.f., as will Ulta Beauty. And so we feel really great. And a lot of that has to do with the strategic imperatives we put in place, our partnership with them, and our fundamental value equation and how well it's been doing. We're the most productive brand that Target and Walmart carry, and we mean to keep it that way.
Now, I was watching a TikTok video of famous people putting on your makeup. Can you do that again? There were something, I mean, the number of views. I mean, we're talking about like billions of views. That seemed like quite a creative thing to do.
Well, I think it goes back to our roots. We're a digital disruptor. People thought we're crazy 16 years ago to sell cosmetics over the internet for $1 each. So we're always looking for different ways of engaging our consumers. You and I have talked in the past about the selfie generation and the millennials, and you know, we appeal really strongly to them. Well, I'd tell you the Gen Z generation is a TikTok generation. So when we decided to do something on TikTok, we decided to do something very different. We created our own eyes of space, hashtag challenge, creating our own music track. And you're right, it has been an incredible viral sensation. There's now over 5.4 billion views, over 3.5 million videos. And I think it really talks about our ability of really connecting with a generation that loves this brand.
Now, one of the things that's happening recently is I've had to do a couple of speeches, and I was also at two Zoom parties, okay? One a sad one, one a happy one, and I do a Zoom video with my kids every Sunday, okay? And what I've discovered, sir, is something that Fabrizio Freda from Estee Lauder told me, which is that you better believe that you need makeup. It's not just the selfie generation, it's the Zoomy generation. Are you finding, as we get deeper and deeper in Zoomy, that people realize they don't look as good as they'd like to? Plus, they look at themselves. I think it is, I don't go on it without makeup. Now, that's because I'm vain and older. But I don't take my makeup off when I go home if I'm on a Zoom. It's really, you need makeup for Zoom.
Well, you definitely need makeup, not only for Zoom, for many occasions. And the great thing about us is we have these products that are prestige quality, these incredible values. So a great product for kind of the Zoom generation is our Poreless Putty Primer. And it's something we can uniquely do. It's not only the number one primer in the U.S., but it's now the number one face product in the face category in the U.S. And the reason why is our ability to create these products. Our Poreless Putty Primer is $8. The next best product to it is a prestige item for $52. And not only is Poreless Putty Primer great for when you're on Zoom, but we've been getting these great notes from nurses that say, you know, well, they're afraid with putting their masks on to put makeup and soil the mask. Poreless Putty Primer saved their face. And so our strength in complexion in many of these core categories, including skincare, is really doing great things for our business and, more importantly, for consumers.
Well, my wife has it. We have it in our drawer. It's just something that's, you know, you're pretty prevalent. I don't know what these proxy guys want, but I think you've come through it great. And that's just my view. But one husband of someone who uses it. And I want to thank Tarang Amin, the chairman and CEO of E.l.f. Beauty. Congratulations, sir. I think you're doing everything right in a very tough environment.
Thank you very much.
All right. And let me tell you guys, I think that this is one where you can win either way. And here's a sneak peek at what my great friend Sarah Eisen has coming up in Markets in Turmoil at 7 p.m. on CNBC. Man Money's back after the break.
Tonight at 7 p.m., the nation's savings rate hits an all-time high as Americans stockpile their cash. At what point does that hit the economy? Plus, the Alabama mayor that's trying to battle a health crisis as his city becomes a hotspot for the virus. And three business owners on their troubles, their hopes, and their path forward. All tonight at 7 p.m. Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.